Now, you're an eye doctor and you wear eyeglasses.
Right. I'm in that, I have to admit it, over 40 crowd.
Okay.
John, yeah.
Yeah. Most of us are there. I'm a tad over 40. I think that's a tad times two over 40, actually. And I'll let you do the math on that. I can see myself starting to squint. I'm lucky that I, at this age, have not had any kind of need for eyeglasses. But I'm thinking, all right, maybe this is the time.
It's funny. It often seems to happen overnight. It takes people 40 or 45 years to get there. But all of a sudden, you wake up one morning and, gee, I can't see anymore.
Yeah, exactly. Now, those eyeglasses that you're wearing, because, you know, you go in, and I've taken my mom in for eyeglasses, and she's worn them all of her life. And, I look at the walls of different frames and all of the different brands are there. Now, are those Ferrari glasses that you're wearing? What are they?
Lamborghini.
Yeah, they're Lamborghini. What are they? Is that a Porsche that you got on?
Actually, what I'm wearing, this frame, it's a rimless frame. It's got the little line in the edge, so you don't see the edge of the frame so much. But it's in our lowest price category. It's a pretty simple frame. It does the job for me. I like it. It's seems to serve my purpose as well. It's certainly not necessary to spend a ton of money to get a very nice pair of glasses.
What are the differences in the different pairs of the different designs and the different glasses that you can get from the different manufacturers?
Mm-hmm. Well, there is a lot of variation in quality. Of course, you can get some pretty awful cheap frames out there that I see sometimes. There are also some terrific quality frames that are just over the top, things that are made in France and Italy that are gorgeous and stylish. But there's a middle of the road that's lots of terrific quality frames that don't have designer brand names on them, that like the one that I'm wearing here, which are really do the job nicely. They look good. They're stylish. They're not terribly expensive. Of course, there are lots of, and in Hanover especially, we have several different brands that are much more fashionable too.
And that's a big part of it, is how well you look in it. And it always helps. Did you take Mrs. Dr. Sam with you when you picked out those frames? Because it always helps to have somebody else to give you that unvarnished opinion about how you look.
She is the one who has to look at me every morning, right? And she approved this frame. If she had her way, I might be in one of those Burberry frames. But I especially like this frame because it's something that I can wear every day. I actually have the same exact frame in a few different pairs of glasses.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason for that is that I'm always experimenting with the new lenses that come out. We will get it when something interesting comes out. We'll get it, the progressive type lenses.
Do you have the no line bifocals?
Right. The no line bifocal progressive type lens. That's what I use. That's what most people use. Some people do better with the regular flat top bifocal with the straight line in it, especially for certain industrial purposes or being able to see things in certain ways. But most of us like the no line bifocal.
So you have a few pairs of glasses, because most of us only have that one pair, and oh my gosh,
right,
they get broken, they get lost.
Right. And a lot of people have several pairs for fashion reasons. They might have different frames and different colors, especially the ladies who want to coordinate their wardrobes, that type of thing. Not so much of an issue for me, John, I'm afraid, but
it's the guy thing. You have two pairs of shoes,
right?
And way too many casual clothes. And I'm sure the lovely and talented Mary is a little upset about that. That's Dr. Sam's wife, and one pair of glasses. We seem to get by on this Spartan existence.
Right. I may get into the 21st century and get another frame one of these days.
There you go. And again, as we've been talking about with Dr. Sam from Dr. Sam's Eye Care in Claremont and in Hanover, as we look at eyeglass frames, is that there are a number out there with the new progressive no-line bifocal lenses, different types of lenses, and we're not looking at things that are going to break the bank, and that they will work with you and just deal with your budget for eyeglass frames when you come into either location on Dunning Street in Claremont or in Hanover at Doran's Place right behind Yama.
Right. It is mind-boggling, the number of different types of frames and different types of lenses that are available. So that's what we try to do, is weed out all the stuff that we don't need and find the best values, the best quality in all these things.
How do you know that you're getting good value when you're going to pick out eyeglasses?
It's hard to know. It's hard to know in any medical-related field whether you're getting good quality. The things that you need to really look for are, especially when you're getting glasses, first, make sure that they really serve your needs. It's something that you need, you know, you either need it for optical reasons, and the person who's doing your refraction, your eye exam, can assure you that you will have an improvement from it, or you've damaged your old glasses, and there's a good reason for this. Or else, if you want to have a new pair of glasses for fashion reasons, that's fine too. That's also a very reasonable, legitimate reason for having a pair of glasses. It's good to go to a professional establishment that's controlled by a doctor. John, that's an unabashed plug for optometry, okay?
And it should be.
Yeah. It's good to have the optical dispensary overseen by somebody who really understands the optics. And if that's not the case, you can, I can't say everybody's perfect everywhere, but you're a lot more likely, if that's not the case, to have a problem with your glasses, to be unable to adapt to them, to not have it do what you need them to do.
Sure.
Good to find somebody who does their homework, who really looks into all the different quality issues and the function issues and weeds through these things. And then I think of as the last most important thing is you really want somebody who has a transparent fee structure, somebody who, you know, you don't end up in a situation where they say, hey, come on in, we'll get you a pair of glasses for $100 and you end up spending $400. That's not okay.
Now, we've been mentioning fashion eyewear this morning and fashion eyeglasses with Dr. Sam, Dr. Sam's Eye Care in Claremont and in Hanover at WNTK. Do I have to make compromises in the actual quality, the medical quality of the lenses for fashion?
Sometimes compromises are made, and it's something that has to be done intelligently by an optician who really knows what they're doing. There's always trade-offs. People with very high prescriptions often do very well with small frames so that they don't end up with big chunky lenses hanging on their noses.
Mm-hmm.
On the other hand, if you have progressive lenses, you don't want too small a frame because you won't have a big enough reading area.
So
you always have to work with this frame size issue to work with the prescription that's coming in the door.
Right. Yeah. So I can get something that's good, and I know you use excellent materials. Again, without breaking the bank, and that's really the purpose of what we're talking about here.
And of course, there are the materials we use are the best that we can find on the market, and there are less expensive materials, less expensive frames and lenses that are out there. Of course, there, in most cases, especially as far as lenses go, it doesn't pay to go with something less expensive. With frames, it's reasonable to go with less expensive frames sometimes, but there is a reasonable limit too. There are plenty of frames out there that we wouldn't work with.
So, as always, at Dr. Sam's, we're talking about vision first vision.
I'd say that's a good way to put it,
yeah.
John.
Yeah, there it is. And one of the things that you mentioned in some of the commercials, and not being an eyeglass wearer, but pretty close to coming into either Claremont or Hanover, and I've seen this happen with friends who wear glasses, is those little screws, those little teeny tiny screws there, the eye wire screw that gets locked into place.
Right. That can be a bugaboo.
Just to make sure that the lenses stay put, because I've seen people with glasses with lenses that are kind of wobbly.
And you want to make sure everything's staying together. Often frames are dispensed, glasses are dispensed by opticians who don't really make sure that all these things are tight and the way they should be. We actually lock everything in place in a way that you can get it back out again if you need to, but that's solid.
Dr. Sam from Dr. Sam's Eye Care, 9 Dunning Street in Claremont. It's right behind Valley Regional Hospital and, of course, the Hanover location at number 2 Dorrance Place. That's right behind Yama. They're right in the same building. And the number is great, 603-543-2020. That is the easiest telephone number to remember, 603-543-2020. And online at drsamseyecare.com, drsamseyecare.com. Always a lot of fun, Dr. Sam.
Pleasure as always, John.
See you again in a couple of weeks. Dr. Sam from Dr. Sam's Eye Care online at drsamseyecare.com. Time now, 7:55 at News Talk 99.7 WNTK, WNTK.com.